All right, hi guys. It's January 19th at about 12:30 p.m. I'm getting ready to try and do the Marley bun that I saw. So I've already washed, deep conditioned, and slightly blown out my hair. So this is not completely stretched, but I just kind of wanted it to get a little bit dry. So this is my hair, 8 months. Do a quick spin. And otherwise, I'm gonna just let the video record and turn on some music. You probably won't hear it because I'll mute it later. And get started. So, thanks for watching. Alright, here we go.
Alright guys, so I'm going to just start with a basic bang. I'm using regular silver clips and I'm doing a square part. I like my bangs to be right in the front of my head, obviously, with any bang. And I kind of like my temples to be like slick to the sides, and then I like all of the hair in the front. So that's what I'm aiming for right now with this part that I'm doing. So this is my first time doing a narration over the video, so I'm going to do my best to do play-by-plays and kind of remember what happened. But as you know, sometimes you have to watch it a couple of times to really see what's going on. So I did attempt to speed this video up as much as I could, but I am going to eventually, have parts where I won't have anything to say. So I just did put some elastic drop to hold the bang down, and now I'm just going to get ready and add some gel to my hair. I'm going to use the basic Eco Styler gel, and wherever I can dig that out of my basket, I'll show you. And I'm also going to use two brushes, one with more of a felt tip brush, and then one with just more of an airy, it's supposed to be my venomous brush, but I just didn't buy one. So I have two types, one of the harder brushes and then that soft one. So based on the videos that I watched from other YouTubers, they just added the gel directly to the hair, no other product in it, so that's what I'm trying with mine. Going to attempt to slick it down without a full blowout, and I don't know how well this is going to work, so we'll just play it by ear and see. One girl, she used like half a jar, so I'm like, oh, maybe I'll just like keep adding, and I'm going to get this to slick somehow, sticky, and try to get the brush to do it, and my hair is like, no, I don't like it, and it's fighting the brush, and it's a lot of work to get this little fluffy hair slicked down, man. I don't know about you ladies, but I'm like fighting it, so yeah. Alright, so here's the test of fate. See if I can get this bad boy in a ponytail. My hair is too sticky. My hands are too sticky right now, but I'm gonna see if I can pull it into a ponytail. Maybe that would be the true testimony of my growth for 8 months. So we'll see. Looks like it's gonna get there. Oh, I'm fighting it. Oh, here we go. Let's see. Nah, not quite. So, what I'm noticing is my sides aren't cooperating. So, I'm going to continue to try and fight those sides to get in this ponytail. Now, the rest of the back is slicked. The back is slicked up well, and that's holding. The front is already, the bang is already in the section. But now I'm fighting my sides. So this is a quick spin around. I do have a struggle pony, so that's kind of deciding, but the size is gone. So I'm going to try and probably just tie it down, take a shower, come back, and start over again. Maybe once I let it dry a little bit, it'll do a little bit better for me. And as you can see, good old faithful American flag scarf. I don't know why or why I got this scarf, but I love it. It's just the way to do it. I'm going to just tie it down. I'll be back in probably a little bit after it dries down. I'll show you what happens next. Alright, round two. So I double tied it down before I got in the shower and used the nylon and the cotton scarf to try and see what it would be. And that's getting the size down a little bit more, but I'm going to try and tighten the pony a little bit more and see what I can get after it's been dried a little bit more into my hair. So I'm doing the pony brush down one more time, probably two more, three more times, just to see if I can make any improvement on the tightness. So here's the improvement from the last time into the partial dry. A little bit better, not quite, but I'm going to go ahead and start trying to add the hair in just to see what it's going to look like. So this is probably about a pack of Marley hair that I put into rubber band to make like a ponytail version. And then I'm going to attempt to add it on my hair as a ponytail and then do the wrap around like I saw another YouTuber do and see how that goes. But once I looked at it, I took it down to probably a half a pack so I can make a smaller bun because I didn't want too much hair. I'm going to apply a little bit of olive oil to the actual Marley hair so it won't be dry and it'll have some sheen because my rest of my hair has sheen to it. So that's what I'm just applying now, and if you can't see off camera, the greatest. So trying to add it on directly wasn't working, so I decided to add a rubber band to attach to the hair so it could hold on to my struggle pony and then be easier to wrap around. And that made a little bit more sense. So now I'm just going to try and start wrapping. I'm going to go one way with one part of the hair and another way with another. And I also decided that maybe braiding it would make it a little bit better. But of course it came off. So I'm going to start again. So I need some pins to hold the hair in place once I can finally attach it to my hair. So I have regular bobbies and then straight pin bobbies to attach the hair with, which I just showed you if you missed those. And we start wrapping. See what we can do. I look like a unicorn right now, like I have my little bang up top and then I'm trying to add this hair on. So I tried to do a high bun, the sides are still peeping out. I made a little crown piece to make a crown with it and I'm trying to add that on now. Maybe that'll make it a little bit, the sides look so not so obvious. I don't know what I'm doing at this point, I'm just playing around at it really. Now what I noticed once I put the hair on is that the texture of it, it didn't match the braids like I wanted it to, and then it was too much hair, so it looked like I had a beehive on my head. I just looked awful. So I decided maybe if I take it down and make a low pony, it won't be so awkward on the top of my head. So I'm just starting the process over again, taking it to a low bun. So this is a low bun. I don't really, it looks like it's just too much hair. So, still gonna try and see what the finish effects of adding the crown does to it and see how it looks. But right now, I'm just trying to finish the looks for you guys, but I'm not liking it in my mind. You can see the frustration on my face. So I think I just used too much hair. I'm gonna just take this off and I'm gonna go straight into my favorite hairstyle, the high puff with the bang. So that's what I'm gonna go into now. I'm just gonna leave the hair in for right now until I get to that part of my hair, but I'm gonna work on my bangs. I'm gonna apply a little bit of the moisture butter to make the twist in the front of my hair. That's what makes the bangs a little fluffy, and I usually wear the twist in front for a little bit. And then towards the end of the week, I'll actually take those out and I'll wear them fluffy. And I won't bore you with me twisting my whole bangs. Like, you take the hair, you twist it towards the front, and then you twist. It's not very much magical things to it. So I'm going to probably just continue twisting those, and I'm going to fast forward in a little bit and just get to the point. Okay, we're back. So, I tried to do at least like a couple for you guys so you could see. And I'm going to go ahead and take this hair out, and then I'm going to moisturize the back of my hair with a little bit of water and olive oil. Fluff it out. I'm adding some nylon and a bra strap to hold the hair securely and just kind of let that hold for a little bit. The bra strap isn't tight enough, so I have to redo it a couple of times, so you can see me do that. So I realized I have to be somewhere in the next couple of hours, so I have to try and speed up the process. So I decided to add cotton to the back of my hair because that'll soak up the moisture a little bit better than the nylon to hold the hair up, and then that'll help also hold up the back of my hair so I can fluff out a little bit better. July, I took the nylon off and switched to cotton. So, sorry if I keep showing you guys my shirt. I was trying to train it, but the buttons weren't cooperating. And you'll probably start noticing it now because I just said something, but it just was bothering me. I kept buttoning it up and kept popping open. Anyway, so now I'm just adding a little bit of heat to my hair, not directly into it, just trying to puff it out. Because I can't go outside in the winter with wet hair. I'll continue to add a little bit of heat, blow it out to try and get a little bit more fluff. Nothing really special about it. Just don't want to really go outside with completely wet hair. I'll put the bra strap back on, add the nylon a little bit later, and that'll really be about it. I really do thank you guys for watching. I know this is a long video, and this is my first voiceover, so let me know how I did. So I'm kind of trying to figure out how to do it. Yeah, right. Anywho, thank you for watching. I really do appreciate it. Definitely make sure you rate, comment, subscribe, and enjoy.